Hello, this is Dr. Glassbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will learn what Boolean logic is and how we can use it to define logical rules using truth tests. The next function we will be discussing from the dplyr package is filter, which allows you to pass inputs that define logical rules for querying a dataset. These logical rules are statements that evaluate to one of two outputs, either true or false. You can also chain these rules together, so long as they ultimately result in a single true or false as output. Working with true and false values in this way is a form of Boolean logic. There are two primary components that can be used to compose rules, which are comparisons and logical operators. Comparisons resemble the inequality statements that you should have seen in your mathematics courses. Comparisons check if numerical values are greater than, less than, or equal to a test value. In R, you can use the following symbols to build a comparison test: greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, not equal, and equal. Note that for the not equal, the negation is symbolized with the exclamation point symbol, and for equal, we use two equal signs. The logical operators are the other component we use to compose rules. Logical operators allow us to chain rules together. In R, the logical operators are AND, represented by the ampersand, OR, represented by the bar, NOT, represented by the exclamation point, and exclusive OR, which is handled by the XOR function. Here are a couple of R examples showing how the operators work. The AND operator returns true only if there is a true on the left side and right side. If you have true and true, you get a true back. If you have a true and false, that returns a false. Same thing with a false and false. The OR operator returns a true if just one of the two sides contains a true. So true OR true returns a true. True OR false returns true. False OR true returns true. But false OR false returns a false. The OR operator is handy when you only need one of several rules to match. The exclusive OR operator is a lot like the regular OR operator. True XOR false returns true, false XOR true returns true, and false XOR false returns false. However, true XOR true returns false, unlike the regular OR operator. The NOT operator converts true to false and false to true. This is often combined with the other operators. So if you want to write true and not false, we will get true back. That is because not false is the same as true. This schematic of Venn diagrams visually represents how the logical operators work. The left circle is represented by the variable x, and the right circle is represented by the variable y. The sections of the circles are shaded with gray to represent what a given rule will match. Starting in the first column, we see the first example, which says y and not x. This statement returns the non-overlapping portion of the right circle. Below that is the statement x and y. This returns the overlapping region only. Below that is x and not y, which returns the non-overlapping portion of the left circle. In the second column is x, which returns the full left circle. Below that is x exclusive OR y, which returns the non-overlapping regions of the left and right circles. Below that is y, which returns the full right circle. In the third column is x OR y, which returns all of the regions of the Venn diagram.